What's up, Team Unaltered? As you can see, we took a shot in honor of today's topic of alcohol and weight loss of tequila Patron, not only in honor of the video, but just because I like Patron. So today we are talking about alcohol, its effect on your weight loss goals, and what are the best alcoholic beverages that you should be drinking when you are trying to lose weight. Now, I wanna preface this by saying that I'm not trying to promote excessive drinking.
Two shots of vodka.
This is not a discussion on whether or not alcohol is good or bad for you, right? This is simply trying to look at alcohol from a caloric standpoint as it pertains to your weight loss goal so that you can make the best decisions when you're going out in a social setting and drinking alcohol to keep you on track with your weight loss efforts and to prevent that number on the scale from going up, right? So first, I'm going to go over some pitfalls of alcohol and how it is derailing your weight loss, and then make sure that you stay tuned until the end of the video where I'm gonna be going over the best alcoholic beverages, best liquors to be drinking to make sure that you are on track with your weight loss goal. So let's jump right into it. Number one, we're talking about calories. Now, according to the CDC, right, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, they say that most adults who drink, which is about 60 to 70% nationwide, according to the NIH, do not drink every day. So again, most adults who drink do not drink every day. However, adults when they do drink at any given social setting or event have on average 3 to 6 alcoholic beverages, right? So the problem is that even though we don't drink every day, when we do drink, we're ending up having a week's worth of calories in just one night of fun.
Hey, hey, shut up, Steve. Hey, no, hey, I ain't gonna take another shot. No, hey.
Right, and the thing is that alcohol has 7 calories per gram versus nutrients like protein and carbohydrates that only have 4 calories per gram. And it seems like a low number, but it ends up becoming a lot when you end up having several drinks and it loads up on calories. And you're gonna see that now as we go down the list of the most popular and highest calorie alcoholic beverages. Starting with number one, we are going over the Long Island Iced Tea, right? Now the standard 7-ounce glass of Long Island Iced Tea is 780 calories. Now I need to stop here for a second because this is huge, guys. 780 calories. In my last video, I was talking about figuring out what your maintenance calories are and the fact that you need to reduce your daily caloric intake by 500 to 1,000 calories a day to lose on average about 1 to 2 pounds per week, right? So if you're having a Long Island iced tea, that's 780 calories already. You're already well beyond your 500 calorie to 1,000 calorie limit that you need to reduce a day to lose weight. So instead of losing 1 to 2 pounds per week, you're gonna end up gaining 1 to 2 pounds per week. So that is a very calorically dense drink, the Long Island iced tea. Number two in line, we have the famous margarita, right? Margarita, an 8.5-ounce glass, standard glass of margarita is 740 calories, so still a lot of calories. Number three, we have the pina colada, right? The standard 6-ounce glass of pina colada is 640 calories. Going on to number four, we have beer, standard 12-ounce of beer is 150 calories. And then we have, last but not least, wine. Regardless if it's red wine or white wine, a standard 5-ounce glass of wine is 120 calories. Now, I'm not talking about the benefits, right? I know that some people say that red wine is healthier than white wine. I'm not talking about the health benefits. I'm specifically looking at alcohol from a caloric standpoint. And regardless if you go red or if you go white, a standard 5-ounce glass of wine has 120 calories. So you can see that the calories can easily pack on by just having a few drinks and having fun, right? So we need to try to limit our alcohol intake. Going on to number two, we have diuretic, right? Alcohol is a diuretic, which means that it promotes the excretion of water and in turn makes you dehydrated, right? And when you have a dehydrated body, you have a plethora of issues, right? One, you have a slower metabolism. Number two, you have less intracellular water in your muscles, right? Our muscles are made up 70% of water. So when you have a dehydrated muscle, it's working less efficiently to burn calories. And muscle burns more calories than fat. So you wanna have nice hydrated muscles to make sure that our body is operating efficiently and we're burning as many calories as possible. Last but not least, diuretics limit blood flow, right? So less nutrient absorption and higher blood pressure. So just for overall health and for burning more calories, we wanna make sure that, again, we're limiting our alcohol intake. My tip here is that every other drink that you have, let it be a cup of water. So if you have an alcoholic beverage, the next drink that you should have is a cup of water, and then you go back to the alcohol and vice versa, right? You keep having a cup of water every other drink to make sure that you keep your body nice and hydrated, right? Going on to number three, we have fuel priority, right? This is the order at which your body burns different types of fuels, right? First, you have alcohol. Your body will first try to burn alcohol. After the alcohol is burned, it will go to carbs. It will then go to protein. And then lastly, it will go to fats, right? And your liver takes about an hour to process just 1 ounce of liquor, right? And most standard drinks, regardless of where you go, if it's a bar or restaurant, most bartenders use 1 to 1.5 ounces of liquor in any type of alcoholic beverage, right? So it's essentially a 1-to-1 ratio, right? If you have 3 drinks, it's gonna take 3 hours for your liver to metabolize it, right? So you can see here that the more you drink, the longer it's gonna take for your body to burn through the alcohol so that it can then get to the fat, right? So we wanna try to, again, limit our alcohol intake, because the more that you drink, the longer it's gonna take for your body to be able to get rid of that alcohol and then start burning the fat, which is exactly what we want. Last but not least, it simply comes down to judgment. Now, we know that judgment is the first thing that gets impaired when we drink alcohol, right? And I'm not talking about drinking and driving. I am talking about poor food choices, right? We drink and we get drunk, right? Even if we're not plastered, maybe we have a light buzz. When you drink alcohol, your hormones are running all over the place and you want a nice, calorically dense, right? Fat, carbohydrates, whether it's a cheeseburger, French fries, a milkshake, right? You end up making poor food choices when you are drunk versus being sober, right? I've never been in a car full of drunk people and somebody said, when we're at the drive-thru, yeah, let me get the salad without the croutons and without the cheese, right? That doesn't happen. We make poor food choices.
I'll have 2 number 9s, a number 9 large, a number 6 with extra dip, a number 7, 2 number 45s, 1 with cheese, and a large soda.
And it's just a normal thing that we do when we have a few drinks. So we wanna try to consciously make healthier food choices or just limit our alcohol intake so that we don't get to that point where we're, you know, starving for a cheeseburger or something that is gonna derail our weight loss efforts, right? So these are the 4 different things to derailing your weight loss. Now, going to the best alcoholic drinks, liquors that you should be drinking when you go out that are the lowest calorie options to help you in your weight loss goals. Number 1, this is my personal favorite. This is my go-to drink every time that I go out in any social setting, and it is the vodka soda, right? Vodka, club soda, and lime, right? This is 60 calories for a standard 8-ounce drink of vodka, club soda, right? Club soda has 0 calories. The only calories that you're having is from the vodka, which has 60 calories per ounce, right? So the vodka soda is my go-to. That is the lowest calorie option. Number 2 in line, we have tequila. That's what we just had before this video, right? A standard 1-ounce shot of tequila has 95 calories per shot. So still a pretty low calorie option. Now, this is not considering mixers, right? This is just straight liquor. As soon as you start adding mixers like Cokes, juices, right? Tonic water, you just wanna stay away from those, right? All of those mixers have an average of 100 to 150 calories per 8 ounces, right? So tonic water, Coca-Cola, any juice mixers, you wanna try to stay away from those. If you're gonna have tequila, maybe just stick to a little shot of lime juice, which is the same thing that we just did before this, right? Stay away from the mixers. Next in line, light beer. If you're having beer, try to go with the light options, right? A light beer, instead of 150 calories, you go down to 100 calories, which is definitely better. So always try to stay to the light options if you're gonna have beer. And then last in line, we have the mojito. A mojito has 110 calories. Still somewhat low, but the lowest option, again, this is the winner, the vodka soda. This is my personal go-to, lowest calorie option, vodka, club soda, and lime, right? So I hope that this video helped you. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch it. I wanna hear from you. Leave a comment below. What is your favorite alcoholic beverage? Tell me, leave a comment below. Thank you again. Until next time, Team Unaltered, out.